That's the same Nairobi Senator Johnson Sakaja, a man who needs no introduction. So he will tomorrow be arraigned in court to face charges of flouting containment measures. Sakaja, who presented himself at Kilimani Police Station to record a statement, also announced his resignation as the chairperson of the Senate Ad Hoc Committee on COVID-19 situation and apologized to Kenyans for flouting the COVID-19 regulations.
Nairobi Senator Johnson Sakaja arrived at Kilimani Police Station around 10 a.m., accompanied by his Senate colleague and lawyer Mutula Kilonzo Jr. Sakaja presented himself to the DCI officers at the station a day after reports of his arrest for flouting curfew orders emerged on Saturday morning. Senior counsel John Haminwa, who is also part of Sakaja's defense team, was also at the station. He was grilled at the station for almost an hour, where he recorded a statement.
Sakaja has no alternative. He has to appear in court tomorrow. They have made up their minds. But we don't know what offense, but they seem to have made up their minds to take him to court tomorrow.
Shortly after, the Nairobi senator was released and took responsibility for his actions.
On Friday, it was not any official duty. I was not oversighting, I was not looking at what they're doing. I was on the wrong on that one, and I agree. And I'm sorry for that. I apologize to Kenya.
Sakaja also announced his resignation as the chair of the Senate Ad Hoc Committee, which has been assessing the COVID-19 preparedness in counties.
That I resign from the Ad Hoc Committee on COVID, which I've been chairing. We have done a lot of work so far. I support the work that the government is doing and the officers. I think they're doing a good job across the country. But because of that responsibility and the example they need to set, I have this morning officially written to the speaker about that.
The senator is expected to appear in court tomorrow to answer to charges of flouting the curfew regulations, which attracts a fine not exceeding 20,000 shillings or imprisonment for a period not exceeding 6 months or both.